Hello, it's me again, Professor Rachel Baranova from George Mason University. Hello, hello. So today we have wonderful news. We have news that FDA voted to approve Novavax vaccine, which is recombinant vaccine against coronavirus. We waited for this for a very long time. Of course, this approval is not final approval by FDA. It's just panel which voted 21-0. So 21 were for the vaccine. One was just not voting, and and nobody was against the vaccine. So for sure it will be approved by FDA. We are expecting to hear about it within the next few weeks, of course. But this is more than just another vaccine. First of all, this news is very important for United States for a couple of reasons. One is that we will have a chance to change the platform if we need to. So right now there are three vaccines available: Pfizer, Moderna, and also Johnson & Johnson. Pfizer and Moderna are mRNA vaccines, Johnson & Johnson adenoviral vaccine. But adenoviral vaccine recently got limited in its use by FDA warning because there were some coagulation events associated with vaccine. And because of that, this vaccine right now is only offered to people who cannot get a mRNA vaccine, which basically means that whoever wants to get vaccinated, those people would get a mRNA vaccine. With approval of new vaccine, Novavax, now we can change platform. We can not just go between Moderna and Pfizer, but we can go to entirely new platform, which is a recombinant platform. So whoever was not happy with RNA or not happy with adenoviruses as idea, they can get this recombinant traditional technology made vaccine. But even if it is more traditional vaccine than mRNA vaccine, this is really a breakthrough because of two things. First, this is large-scale production in the insect cells. Insect cells, very good, very cheap, they can grow at the room temperature, they have no requirements for particular pressure of oxygen, particular pressure of CO2, they're very easy to handle, and you can get real high level production of the protein within this system, which is great. Another thing is that this vaccine has very new type of adjuvant. Old adjuvant, example of adjuvant, something which is stimulating immune response, would be aluminum. And a lot of people hate aluminum. There is a reason for it. Because aluminum really shifts our response toward antibody response of G-type, so there will be less of other antibodies produced, but more of the G-type of antibody produced. In case of new adjuvant used in Novavax, this is saponin, new type, based on the plant material. This is a big tree which is growing in Chile. And that was one of the problems with vaccine in the beginning, at inception, because the scale-up has to happen in order to get a lot of this adjuvant. The vaccine is literally grown in a tree. Those are large trees, 100 or more years old, and you cannot really kill so many trees in order to get this saponin for the vaccine. So there was a technological process which was developed, take the parts of the tree, not the bark, but leaves and other soft things which grow back, and then you modify it in the lab to make the final product. And that took time, of course. So there were a couple of things which were obstacles in development of this vaccine. One is that saponin production should be extended. Second is that because the baculovirus production is such a new thing that, it's not really super new thing because scientists did it, but they did it on the smaller scale. And even recombinant products were done at the industrial scale in baculoviruses, but never at such large industrial scales. So there were various kinds of technological things which need to be unclogged before you start doing large-scale production. For example, there is such thing as standardization. We need to really have all the batches of the vaccine made as good as possible, as tight in the composition as possible. And it was very difficult for this particular vaccine. So there were differences in composition that took about a year to get all the wrinkles out. Even vaccine is United States made, Novavax, United States company, located in the Maryland. But it was impossible to do all this within United States because the production for the vaccines, the lines which were already existing, were occupied by production of other vaccines. So it was moved to India, produced in the Serum Institute in India. And then with those already tightly set vaccine batches, where there is no difference in various kinds of components, were tested, and they were tested in Europe. They already approved in 40 different countries. And finally, this product got to United States. So we've got a vote, 21 for the vaccine. And there was one person who was not voting, and this person was Bruce Gehlen, who used to be director of the vaccine division in the Department of Health and Human Services, and he's right now in the Rockefeller Foundation, in the part of the Rockefeller Foundation which deals with vaccines. So Bruce Gehlen was not voting, and there was a reason for it. The reason why he was not voting is that, and this is very, very important reason, that this vaccine was not tested in Omicron. It just took so long time to get the vaccine from the point where it was proven to be efficient to the point when there is large-scale production, which is large-scale enough to actually distribute in population. Then there were five ways passing since that. So the vaccine was tested when there was alpha, and there was beta. It was not even tested on Delta variant. And we really do not know how good vaccine is in the Omicron. Also, vaccine was tested in two doses, 21 days apart, like Pfizer vaccine, for example, in the same way. Yes, only it is recombinant vaccine, not mRNA vaccine. It has been tested, and it's proven efficient in naive populations, meaning in populations who were not exposed to virus and they were not exposed to vaccine as well. Right now, when we will be using this vaccine, we will be using this vaccine as third shot, as a booster, rather than as primary vaccine. So we kind of making a leap of faith here. We are saying that, okay, you don't need to retry this vaccine in the booster settings, but we believe that it would be good alternative for the booster shots in those who didn't get efficient booster by mRNA in front of coming new waves, etc. So that is a reasonable biological assumption which we are having here. And I think it's good. I think that it's a real good choice. We expect that in the few next weeks we will have final approval from FDA, and then we will have it in CVS and Walgreens and everywhere. So real good news. Congratulations. Now we are having more choices like Europe does. Now not only Pfizer and Moderna and a little bit of Johnson & Johnson, but also recombinant Novavax vaccine. Okay, thank you so much. Bye.